You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of The Casual Vacancy, a famous work by J.K. Rowling. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. J.K. Rowling is an English writer famous the world over for her Harry Potter book series. She was born in Gloucestershire in 1965 and wrote stories as a child before studying French and classics at Exeter University. Her earlier career took her to Portugal, where she taught English as a foreign language, but she returned to the UK when her marriage to a Portuguese journalist failed. Struggling to make ends meet for herself and her daughter, she began writing what would become the Harry Potter series in cafes. By the turn of the century, she was a hugely successful children's author. The Casual Vacancy, published in 2012, is Rowling's first novel for adults. She has written 4 crime novels to date, centering on private detective Cormoran Strike. She used the nom de plume Robert Galbraith so as to hide her authorship of the novels, to see if they could be successful without her famous identity attached to them. When she was revealed as the true author, sales naturally skyrocketed. Rowling also has a career in film, working as a producer on the last few films in the Harry Potter franchise, and turning her hand to screenwriting for the Fantastic Beasts film franchise, an expansion of her Harry Potter universe. The work. Given that The Casual Vacancy was written by one of the richest and most famous authors who has ever lived, it was a highly anticipated publication. Reviews of the novel were mixed, but 1 million copies were sold in English within a month of publication. In 2015, the novel was adapted into a 3-part television series broadcast on the BBC. The novel is set in Pagford, a small parish council in the southwest. The events of the novel are triggered by the death of Barry Fairbrother, a parish councillor who was born in the nearby council estate, the fields, and climbed the social ladder to live comfortably in middle-class Pagford with his family. Barry touched the lives of many people around him, and he is the thread that holds the novel together. His parish council seat, the casual vacancy of the title, is bitterly contested between 2 rival factions, one that wishes to continue Barry's legacy and one that seeks to destroy it. Summary. The death of Barry Fairbrother. The novel begins with the death of Barry Fairbrother, a local councillor, who collapses in a restaurant car park accompanied by his wife Mary. As the news of Barry's fatal aneurysm spreads, his connections to almost everyone in the town are conveyed in the reactions of various characters. Many people are devastated, like Colin Wall, who, despite his social awkwardness, managed to forge a friendship with Barry. Parminder Jawanda, a GP and fellow counselor, is shocked at how painful she is finding the death of a friend. Crystal Whedon, meanwhile, tries to act like she does not care, but is clearly deeply affected by the death of her rowing instructor cum mentor. Howard Mollison, on the other hand, is secretly thrilled at Barry's death given that they were political opponents on the council. A subsection of the first part of the novel entitled Olden Days lays out the central political schism that divides the community. The Fields is an impoverished council estate located between Pagford and Yarvel that belongs, for now, to the parish of Pagford. Barry Fairbrother was born in the Fields and worked his way up the social ladder to reside comfortably in Pagford. He is in favor of keeping the Fields a part of Pagford so that the estate's residents can benefit from St. Thomas's, an excellent primary school in Pagford. Howard Mollison wants the Fields reassigned to Yarvel, the nearby town, as he does not want Pagford to have to deal with the social problems of the Fields. He is buoyed in his opinion by the fact that another pupil at St. Thomas's who came from the Fields, Crystal Whedon, punched his granddaughter Lexi so hard in the face when they were younger that she lost 2 teeth. The council was evenly divided on this issue before Barry's death, but Howard now sees an opportunity to tip the balance in his favor. Meanwhile, 3 contenders for Barry's empty seat emerge: Colin Cubby-Awall, who wants to continue his friend's legacy, Simon Price, who mistakenly believes that being a councillor will pay handsomely in bribes, and Miles Mollison, Howard's son. All 3 candidates lack the support of some of their family members. Tessa Wall thinks her husband is not stable enough, nor as charismatic as Barry, to fulfill the role. Colin's adopted son Stuart, also known as Fats, despises his father and would not support him in any endeavor. Simon Price is abusive to his family, and his son Andrew, Fats' best friend, detests his father and predicts that his election attempt will lead to family humiliation. Simon's wife Ruth is encouraging, but only out of fear of her husband's fist. Miles Mollison enjoys the devoted support of his parents Howard and Shirley, but enrages his frustrated wife Samantha, who loathes watching her boring husband slowly morph into her repulsive father-in-law.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.